North Korea. We don't know much about it, especially as Americans. Our media is totally biased against it because we are allied with South Korea. The DMZ is the demilitarized zone between South Korea and North Korea. It's 2 miles wide and it goes along the 38th parallel. So if you heard that line in Parasite where Mr. Park is like, "Oh yeah, you drive so well," and Mr. Kim is like, "I know everything beneath the 38th parallel," he basically meant, "I know everything in South Korea because the border goes along the 38th parallel." If you didn't know why that happened in the movie, now you know. I had nothing in mind. I couldn't even picture it going into it. I still really can't, but now I've kind of done a little bit more research after visiting the DMZ documentary showing North Korea. I'll link that in the description if you want to watch. And I also happened to watch Crash Landing on You, K-drama on Netflix, about a South Korean woman who ends up in North Korea and has a romance with a North Korean soldier. So it was so dramatic.
발밑을 잘 보면서 나가시오.
다신 안 볼 거라서 하는 말인데 얼굴 완전 내 취향이에요. 통일되면 우리 다른 식으로 봐도 좋을 듯?
Anyways, me and my sister went to check it out for ourselves. Obviously, you can't go into North Korea. Some people can if you get like some kind of permit. I'm not sure how that's done. And we heard that the tour was both sad but also uplifting and hopeful for a future where the two countries were unified. So my sister and I hopped on a bus, picked us up really early. Also, if you're interested in this tour, there's a link in my description through Viator, which is run by TripAdvisor. That is an affiliate link, so if you book through this link, it would help me with all this free information that I give you guys. Anyways, it was about $45 per person. We start driving towards the border, less than an hour maybe, and the tour guide gave us a whole bunch of information. Also, you need to have your passport on you because once you cross into the DMZ, a soldier is going to check your identification. First thing we did on the tour was we visited this park. Things that were interesting there was this wall and the barbed wire, but these bright ribbons. Then this train said that it had 1,020 bullet holes in it, and you can see it here in the footage. Shows the situation during the Korean War and how violent it was. Also, you can see that the train tracks just end here because they would go on to cross the bridge into North Korea, but they don't, obviously. And seeing signs like this where you're at a train station in South Korea and the next stop is in North Korea, but it doesn't continue, it's just really surreal. Park was really nice. There was this lake and this bridge, but it went to nowhere. But it felt like unfinished, like there was something there that was missing. Obviously, there was just a border that stopped everything from continuing on that way. And I kind of wanted to see what was behind it, and it ended up just being a guard tower. And then we climbed up into this kind of observatory. Couldn't really see much from up there, but it was your last stop before going into the DMZ. When you get to the DMZ, a South Korean guard comes onto the bus and checks everyone's passports. And then we went into the DMZ, and the forest was super dense. We did hear about people who live in the DMZ. They are technically South Koreans, but they're not allowed to leave the DMZ. So they just live there, and they're mostly farmers, but they don't have a lot of the same perks that South Koreans outside of the DMZ do have, like being able to move freely. So that was really interesting. I bought this chocolate. I'm gonna go find it. And it says DMZ somewhere on it. DMZ. So this chocolate was made by the farmers there. Yeah, so we got this at a souvenir shop to support the locals in the DMZ. Walk up this hill to the observatory. It's called Dora Observatory, but that was my favorite part of the tour. We actually got to look into North Korea. We were up high enough and close enough to see into the North Korean side of the DMZ. We were able to see an actual village on the other side, and it's called Peace Village, but apparently it's empty. So another name for it is Propaganda Village. They say it was made for show and it's not even being occupied. So that was crazy. They also told us about this interesting story about how the North Korean side and the South Korean side both have these flagpoles, and one side would make theirs a little bit taller than the others, and so then they would just keep like building it higher and building it higher and building it higher. Finally, North Korea got it up to like a certain point that South Korea was just like, "We're just gonna let it go. You guys can have this one." And so you can see it is slightly taller. Then we go outside and there's this playground, and we swing on these swings. Some people were kind of looking at us like, "Why would they swing here? It's a serious situation." There's a sign there, and I forget exactly what it said, but this park was made to celebrate life, to help you be joyous, to uplift you and remind you to be happy despite the circumstances. Because you never know when something crazy drastic is gonna happen and you just don't see a family member or a loved one again. And that's basically what happened. So my sister and I swang and it was really beautiful and it kind of lifted that sadness off of our chest and we laughed. The space asked us to do that. So that was really beautiful. And the whole experience was a combination of understanding history and the heaviness of it, but being present in the moment and being grateful for what you do have. Last part of the DMZ tour, we went to Dorasan Station, the last stop, and there's an actual metro that goes there. There's a sign that says to Pyongyang, and our tour guide told us that it's a symbol of hope for future unification between the two countries. I thought it was really beautiful. The whole tour was really informative, and I feel like I know less about the situation, and I'm more just humbled about it, because to think we know something, we realize we don't know anything, and we're usually wrong. I absolutely recommend visiting the DMZ if you go to South Korea, because there's this whole other half of the country that's there that is inaccessible to us. So to at least see the DMZ, I think, is to honor that history that is present. So that's the moral of my story, is travel, see the world, be open-minded. If you feel like you're not yet open-minded but you want to be, traveling will do that for you. If you have any more questions about visiting the DMZ, other things that we did in Seoul, I didn't film a whole lot in Seoul. It was towards the end of the 6-week trip that my sister and I took, and I was like tired. I was starting to feel a little bit homesick, but I have a whole bunch of pictures on my Instagram, so follow me here. I filmed a whole bunch in Japan, so you can go and check out those videos. I am planning on posting a couple videos from Seoul. Yeah. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe, like, comment, all of the above, and I will see you in the next video. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Blah, 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 blah.